deadly problems on the roads. Mima says a driver hit an 18-wheeler stopped on the side of the road in Smith County and died. A 16 WAPT Jennifer Ortega reports many people were left stranded across the state. She begins our team coverage.
Some travelers have been stranded in the terminal for days, and this cot to sleep on is as good as it's going
to
get.
I'm heading to Hattiesburg, Mississippi, and that's like 82 miles away, and it's hard to get there, and we've just been sitting here.
The polar blast has people at the Jackson bus station sleeping on the floor. They're restless and waiting on buses.
Today they told me probably this afternoon, and later they say tomorrow, and then for real I don't know now.
One traveler never made it to her mother's funeral.
Today was the funeral. I was supposed to be there this morning, so I missed it.
Cold, kind of depressing. I don't understand why we haven't went anywhere yet.
In downtown Natchez, folks unable to leave their homes, snowed in, streets still covered in a white coat. A day after the storm passed, it's still a dangerous drive.
Jackknife trucks, cars slid off in the medians, into bridges. Some with minimal damage, some with a lot of damage.
One group of people staying busy, tow truck drivers. They've been helping hundreds of stranded motorists since Tuesday. One tow operator's message for drivers.
Slow down. Just slow down.
Back at the bus terminal, it's turned into a game of watching and waiting.
And some travelers are hopeful that the buses will show up tomorrow. In Jackson, Jennifer Ortega, 16 WAPT.